Welcome back to our subtopic, the histogram. And the examples I want us to look at now will crown everything on the histogram. And I'm sure by the end of this, you can look for any question testing the histogram and you can be able to get all of them, because there will have been no aspect of the histogram that we have left out. We want to look at two examples, each of which we have histograms which are already drawn for you, but we are expected to work backwards to get frequencies and any other information that the question is looking for. Look at this here. We are told that the histogram below represents the distribution of heights of seedlings of a certain plant. So if you look at it, you will realize that the histogram has been drawn, but the class widths are not uniform. It is evident from this. The class width is not uniform. So it means that although the information here, the question is not giving us what is on the y-axis, you should now know that on the y-axis we have frequency density. So even if the question has not given that, you are now expected to know that we have frequency density. Why? Because the class width is not uniform. We said that when the class width is uniform, then we have frequency on the y-axis, and in that case, all the bars will be having uniform width. So the question is here, that the shaded area in this histogram, you can see that one of the bars is shaded. The bar ranging from 32 to 34 has been shaded. And we are being told that that shaded area represents 20 seedlings. Calculate the percentage number of seedlings with heights of at least 23 but less than 27. We need to look at that area. What is that area that we are given? The width is from 32 to 34, meaning that the width is 2. So area of that bar is equal to 2, and the length we can see is 10, height of 10. So we can see that area is actually 20 as we have been told. So what does that mean? You remember the relationship that area is equal to a constant times frequency. But now when you look at area and you realize it is equal to the number of seedlings, meaning it is equal to the frequency, then it means that this constant is 1. So we can conclude for this particular case that area is equal to frequency, meaning that every bar, if we get its area, then that area is equal to the frequency for that class. If you look at the equation, it is looking at the percentage number, meaning that we need the total number of seedlings here. We have already been given for one bar as 20. In fact, I just want us to work on the bar here so that we get the area of this bar, and that area will be equal to the number of seedlings. Some of them is mental work, because 22 to 23 is just a width of 1 and a height of 5. So the area of that rectangle is 5, meaning that we have 5 seedlings in that class. The next bar is 23 to 26. That is a width of 3 and a height of 10. 3 times 10 is 30. So we have 30 seedlings there. The next bar also has a width of 1 and a height of 15. So it is 1 times 15. See, so that is 15, an area of 15. So we have 15 seedlings because we have said that area for this particular case is equal to the frequency. Look at the next one, 27 to 31, a width of 4 times a height of 20. So the number of seedlings we have there is 8. The area is 8, so that is the number of seedlings. The next class is 31 to 32, a width of 1 and a height of 30, so we have 30. You can see it is simple, and the last one we were given is 20. So the work is simple. Total number of seedlings is the total area. Is the total area, which we can now just do 5 plus 30 plus 15 plus 80 plus 30 plus 20. I hope you are working with me using your calculators or off-head. So you realize that it is a total of 180 seedlings. That is the number of seedlings that we have. But the question is asking, the ones whose height is at least 23 but less than 27. So between 23 and 27, how many seedlings do we have? Between 23 and 26, we have 30 seedlings. Between 26 and 27, we have 15 seedlings, meaning a total of 45 seedlings. So the percentage will be equal to 45 seedlings over the total, which is 180 times 100. That would be 4, 25. So 25%. You can see how this has been tested in a very indirect way. The histogram is already drawn for you. But it is now upon you to understand that when the weight is not uniform, and that is what I want to emphasize, it is the responsibility of you as a candidate to see. This is from TOA, and many may have forgotten, but it is your responsibility to see that as long as the width of the classes is not uniform, then what we have on the y-axis is frequency density. And you can realize that this question cheekily did not even tell you that this is frequency density, so that you use your own common sense and see that. Let us look at the next and the last example. Now, the histogram below represents the distribution of marks obtained in a test. The bar marked A has a height of 3.2, so that height is 3.2, and a width of 5. That information can give us area. The bar marked B has a height of 1.2 and a width of 10. Again, that can give us area. This is the bar marked A and this is the bar marked B. If the frequency represented by bar B is 6, this bar has a frequency of 6. Find the frequency represented by bar A. This question is testing the relationship between area and frequency. That is what I want us to see. We are given the frequency of the bar B, but what is its area? So let us look at area of bar B. The height we have been told is 1.2. So 1.2. The width here is 10. You can see from 74.5 to 84.5 is 10. So that gives us 12. Meaning that the area of that bar is 12. However, we have been told that the frequency for that bar is 6. You can see that the area is not equal to the frequency. Remember, we had said it can only be equal to the frequency if that constant of proportionality is 1. So we need to get the constant, because area is equal to a constant times frequency. So area we have got to be 12 is equal to a constant times frequency, which we have been given as 6 for bar B. So 6 times the constant. From this working, we shall get that that constant is equal to 2. And therefore, we can write the relationship that for this histogram, area is equal to 2 times the frequency. So it is this information that we can now use in bar A to be able to get the frequency represented by bar A. You can now say, area of bar A, the width here is 5, you can see, and the height we have been told is 3.2. So we can work out and find that area of bar A, let me use this space, area of bar A is equal to 5 times height of 3.2, which will give us 16. Then we go to this relationship. For this histogram, area is equal to 2 times the frequency, and we are looking at that for that frequency. We have area, we have the constant, but we are missing the frequency. We shall therefore say that area, which is 16, is equal to 2 times the frequency for bar A. We shall divide by 2 to get that frequency is equal to 8. So the frequency of bar A is 8. You can again see this kind of testing where the bars are already given. We are not even told that whatever we have on the y-axis is frequency density, but that is what it is, because when you look at bar A, you see it has a class interval of 5. The next bar, although there are only 2, the next bar has a class interval of 10. So it means they don't have a uniform class width, and therefore the information on the y-axis is frequency density. This information I want it to be with us, because a histogram is a key area in paper 1, and many candidates are not able to follow because of the aspect of the frequency density. What must stick into our mind is area is directly proportional to the frequency. I want us to remember that area is not just equal to the frequency. Area is only equal to the frequency when the constant of proportionality is 1. But that constant, as we have seen from the workings that we have had, that constant can be 1, it can be 2. The moment it is not 1, then you will find an area which is not equal to the frequency, and therefore it calls upon you to work out to get that constant so that you state the relationship between area and frequency, so that you can be able to work out any other information that is missing. I am sure that with the information that we have gathered now on the histogram as one of the areas of graphical representation of data, which is in Form 2, we are now set and ready to go and look for any question in the past exams. testing a histogram, and I'm sure you will not find challenges. And even if you do, just follow the work we have done. We have looked at all the ways through which a histogram can be tested, and I'm sure if you go through all of them, then any question testing on a histogram, all of you will be able to score. I want us to play with all the graphs. So in our next class, we shall look at the ogive as another way of data representation using graphs before we move on to the other aspects of statistics. Thank you, and God bless you.